Captain, do you have news? How have your efforts with Imperial High Command gone?
Not well, my lord. I've gone as high up the chain as I can. No one will confront Moff Broisk. He's too powerful and entrenched. He will serve until he's killed or willingly steps down. And he will never willingly step down. It seems clear. I must deal with Broisk myself. Once and for all.
This is no different than any other problem. A Sith doesn't care if he's a Moff. Why not kill a Moff? This is your calling, Quinn. Get to it.
I am ready, my lord. My lord, I've returned. I found Moff Broisk on a pleasure barge. He was on R&R while countless battles are raging. Despicable. I abducted him and brought him here to present to you.
Scum! Traitor! You, Sith! I commandeer your ship! Your crew! I commandeer you! Mine, now!
Do you see who has bettered you? The man you wronged has you dead to rights now.
No, never! Not possible! I shunned him! I exiled him! He was to waste away! You are my men now! I command you all! Kill! Kill yourselves! I have spoken!
My lord, I've resisted all along, but this is personal. Permission to execute the Moff.
I will not order it. Do you hate him enough to take responsibility for this?
I believe I do.
You cannot kill me! You are nothing! I am a Moff!
Not anymore.
No! Scabs! All scabs!
The body has been disposed of, my lord. No more of Moff Broisk's men will have to endure his whims and incompetence. Thank you for seeing this through.
You earned it.
The Empire is better off now.
You know, I think I'm getting better at this whole fighting thing. Watching you pick targets for all those hours must have been useful after all.
It's nice to see you improving your skills.
Going to be a sharpshooter any day now. You just wait. So Teeva landed on her feet. She started seeing a Moff stationed in the Outer Rim. He's apparently like 60 years old, though. I don't know what to think.
All that matters is how they get along and feel about each other.
Yeah, I guess you're right. Anyway, Moff old guy apparently has all sorts of contacts in Imperial Intelligence. And I guess he's helping her find Mother. I have dreams about the night they took me from her. Came in the night, pulled me off my sleeping mat. Just screamed and screamed.
You found Teeva. You'll reunite the whole family soon enough.
I hope so. It's nice to know you believe in me.
Got a few leads on the old Black Ops team. Republic won't let the Bastion go easy. It'll take all of us to claim it. Best to start with Lieutenant Tenido. Weapons man. Could turn a hyperdrive into a gun turret if he wanted. Lets it all go to his head, of course. Can't open his mouth except to brag about Black Ops and our wins.
What purpose will he serve in the Bastion assault?
Only way inside the Bastion is the gate.
supposedly impenetrable. Tenido swore he could break through. Took a while to track Tenido down, but he's stationed on Hoth. Finally got a clear comm signal today. You're welcome to listen in. After a few months defrosting blasters, Tenido's probably in rare form.
And then he had me forcibly removed from the armory. Over a few flash grenades. Weapons master indeed.
And after you calibrated all the assault rifles for him too. Shame about those cadets though.
Yes, that was unfortunate. But how was I to know those rifles were for training? They really should use slaves. Anyhow, that's how I ended up on Hoth. Scraping ice from blaster barrels and reheating ammunition. Pathetic.
On Korriban, we use certain officers for target practice.
Then again, Hoth has its charms. The ice crystals form some marvelous patterns.
Maybe you should start tinkering again. Get that weapon you built for the Bastion out of storage.
You know very well that weapon's finished. It's waiting for the assault that will never happen.
I much prefer you cold and miserable on Hoth.
What my lord means to say is that we understand if you can't leave your work. We've got clearance from General Racton. The Bastion's ours for the taking.
Then it's fallen into place. The Bastion. After all these years. I'll get back to base and start making arrangements. When I have the weapon, I'll contact you.
Tenido doesn't like to waste time. He'll have that weapon quick as a Minox wings. Just in time, too. Let the man idle any longer, and he might do some real damage.
I look forward to seeing Tenido unleashed.
Should be a show. Like to see the size of his head after this one. Tenido's weapons will help, but we'll need more than firepower for this one. Assault this big takes reinforcements too. Get back to you about those. Plans for the Bastion assault are coming along. Tenido's got the weapons ready. But having the right ordnance is just the start. Gotta worry about numbers, too. That's Laurent's job. Captain Laurent now. Connection's got her a good post on Balmora. Bend the rules a lot in Black Ops. Laurent could always smooth things out. Pretty face, way with words. People like her.
High praise coming from a man like you.
Just stating the facts. Others might say more. Laurent's a favorite of Moff Galvin. Close to retirement now, but he could give us an army if he had the mind. Ask Laurent about her chances. Seemed to think she could convince the old man. With the right favors.
How did Laurent become Moff Galvin's favorite?
Laurent spent an evening with Moff Galvin as a lieutenant. By morning, she was a captain. Now it's got her putting on airs. Actually ordered me to calm her. Better get to it, eh?
There has to be another way. Moff Galvin has resources, but what he's asking is impossible. The favors I would have to give him now, it would be above and beyond the call of duty.
Never stopped you before, Captain.
The old man's depraved, and the years have not been kind to him.
Surely Moff Galvin wasn't your first promotion.
No, the others were earned, like any good Imperial officer.
You were Black Ops once, before that commission went to your head. Remember?
We do what's necessary to get the job done. Some of us more than others. I'll comm Moff Galvin. Reinforcements will be ready when the time comes.
Wouldn't want to be Laurent right now.
The captain made her bed. Now she must lie in it.
With Moff Galvin? There's an image I didn't need. Security's our last problem. The Bastion will have plenty of systems. Black Ops had a man for that too. Let you know when I find him. Almost ready for the Bastion now. Security's the last wrinkle. Takes a good tech to deal with Republic systems. As is Sergeant Arlos. Rookie. Always trying to prove himself. Near ruined him when Black Ops shut down. Took to drowning his sorrows in the nearest cantina. Sobered up quick when I told him about the Bastion.
The sergeant wasn't assigned to Black Ops by accident.
Lawrence find. Caught him hacking into his own service record. Arlo's could barely aim a blaster when he joined Black Ops. We gave him strength to go with his smarts. Made sergeant after our last assault. Could be up for a commission if things go smooth at the Bastion.
Your victory will depend on his performance.
The Bastion's got some serious security. Alarms, cameras, turrets, the works. Anyone could get us around them, it's our loss. Heard from the kid a few days ago. Said he had some intel ready. Sounded more jittery than ever. We'll find out why.
But I can't account for cheap Republic shortcuts. Who uses a closed circuit system? In the Bastion, no less.
Heard better excuses for my assault rifle. Did you even get their schematics?
No, yes, partly. I have the ground floor layout. That should get you all the way to Central Command.
And what surprises will we find there? That's supposed to be your job, Arlos.
To come so close and stumble at the finish.
I'm starting to think we were shut down for a reason. And the reason was you.
There's something else I could try. It's risky, but I'd get full control of their systems. The Bastion will be ours before we even step inside. Just give me another chance.
Hope so. You screw this up, and I'll personally take it out of your hide. Now get back to work! Schematics look good. With full control, Republic won't have a chance. Kid did all right. Never tell him that, of course. Might make him sloppy. Got to keep him on his toes.
You said security was the team's last concern.
Prep work's finished. The team's ready. Soon as General Racton gives the order, we strike. Just hope it's soon. Can't wait to see those Republic flags burn.
Master, one of the Sith I tried to connect to has contacted me. It seems he's ready to trust us. His name is Lord Emmerich. He's an overseer on Korriban who secretly trains hand-selected acolytes to follow the light.
He risks much operating right under the nose of the Dark Council.
That's why he's seeking me out. Emmerich knows he won't last long. And he's hoping we'll look after his disciples, help consolidate their power, and guide them in the galaxy. With your permission, I'd like to reach out to them and keep in contact.
Use your special power and best judgment, Jacer. Be sure each can be trusted before you draft them.
Yes, Master. I will err on the side of caution always. You're teaching me to find sustenance from within. Independent of outside forces and direct results. And the moment I let go of my need for obvious progress, progress is achieved. This reinforces everything you have told me. Master, I am plagued. It's about Overseer Emmerich. His work is so important. Training Sith acolytes to secretly embrace the light? I sense that he won't be able to hide much longer. If only we could help him find a secure way to continue his efforts.
We should make that a priority.
It wouldn't be time poorly spent. As you have taught me, all that matters is that we try. I'll dedicate myself to doing just that. Perhaps a plan will present itself.
What's on your mind, Brunmark? The peaceful tiles don't respond well to murder. You've long since surpassed the Republic's pathetic order. The tiles lap up the Republic's promises of peace. Soon your kind will be their obedient pawns. We won't stop until the Republic is decimated.
Got time for a cool down.
I'm here as summoned.
Didn't lose you.
My lord, I regret that our paths must diverge. Out of respect, I wanted to be here to witness your fate.
I've got a bad feeling about this.
Your senses have always been keen. It pains me, but this entire scenario is a ruse. There's no martial law and no special signal emitter. Barriss is my true master. He had me lure you here to have you killed.
It figures. You can't trust anyone anymore.
Since your schism with Barriss, I've wrestled with my conscience. And I've watched you destroy countless loyal Imperials while sparing many enemies. I'm convinced you do not have the Empire's best wishes at heart. At least I know Darth Barriss is trying to win this war. Once you're gone, your crew will either join Barriss with me or be killed.
You know who I'm working for now, Captain. If you stand with Barriss, you stand against the Emperor himself.
The Emperor is an absentee landlord. Barriss is doing what any real patriot would do. After all this time observing you in battle, I have exhaustively noted your strengths and weaknesses. These war droids have been programmed specifically to combat you. I calculate a near 0% chance of their failure.
Your confidence in the odds is your biggest weakness.
If anything, I am underestimating my droids' chances. You'll find they are virtually immune to you. I'm sorry it's come to this, my lord. What went wrong? I calculated precisely. You should be dead.
This proves you are inept. I'm better off without someone who makes such a mistake.
Perhaps you're right. I have betrayed you. Conspired with your most hated enemy. I don't expect your mercy.
I will keep you alive, and we will see if you earn my trust again.
My lord, I'm... This is unexpected. Darth Barriss would never forgive such a failure. If you will permit me to stay in your charge, My dedication to you will never come into question again.
I will not hesitate to destroy you the next time.
There will be no next time. I swear. But this interruption has delayed you enough. I'm eager to return to the ship and put this behind us.
The ship is through there. Prepare for departure. I'll join you shortly.
Of course, my lord. One thing, my lord. Do you plan on telling the others what happened?
When it's appropriate, I will inform them.
I appreciate it, my lord. I will see you back at the ship.
She found her! She found her! Mother was sold to a hut on Tatooine years ago. She works in a small shop there. Teeva found her, and she's headed to Tatooine already. We need to go meet her as soon as we can.
Relax, Vet. Breathe.
I am breathing! Okay. Calmer. Oh, and Teeva sent back not only the credits you spent getting her out of that awful place, but a gift. A sign of respect from her old moth. Okay, as soon as we can. Tatooine. I wonder what Mother will think of me now.
A secure message from General Racton. You'll want to hear this.
My lord, I received Lieutenant Pierce's con. I've reinstated Black Ops and excused the team from their prior assignments. If all the preparations have been made, you have Imperial clearance for your assault on the Bastion.
Had a feeling this was it. Hard to believe we're finally making our move.
Play the rest. I want Racton's full briefing.
Due to the massive Republic presence at the Bastion, we've made special arrangements to get Pierce's team within range. You'll infiltrate a shuttle of Republic reinforcements headed for the area. We've already procured the necessary disguises. Surprise is essential, therefore I must ask that you remain behind, my lord. Your presence would expose our plans.
I've got more pressing matters to attend to.
You've got your mission, and Black Ops has ours. Finally.
You made this assault possible, my lord. The credit is yours, should Pierce and his team succeed. The Empire is trusting Black Ops with our victory. I hope it is not misplaced. General Racton out.
The team has their instructions. Have to leave now if I'm going to make the rendezvous.
When the Bastion falls, the Republic will know our power.
So will the Empire. Just how I like it. Gates open, security's down, and the CO is dead. The Bastion belongs to the Empire. Welcome to Black Ops victory, my lord. Long odds, big prize, no survivors.
Were all your preparations worth the effort?
Hit a few snags. Tenido's weapons lost power. Couple of Laurent's men died. Arlos tripped a system hacking in. Took a bit of damage myself. Going to take some time to heal. Let you know when I'm up for a full debrief.
I'm fielding reports from across Imperial forces. Among the men, there's universal relief that Moff Broisk is no more.
The rest of the Empire was passive. It sickens me.
I was guilty of that for a long time.
I feel no conflict over my actions. Broisk was a blight on the Empire. You were guiding me to a new paradigm, my lord. One a bit more improvisational. I believe it will only make me a better officer.
You can bank on that, Quinn.
I will not disappoint you, my lord.
After all this time, to miss her by days.
My condolences, ladies. I can't imagine what you must be feeling right now.
Tiva, what happened?
Ask him. It's his place, apparently.
Mistranja Topa, go makase. Kabanotase makipuna, malituta odmishka.
She doesn't look that old. What killed her?
Moja jo chaluka. Kunachi do nikti toki saya tupi nu aviti.
They still work, believe me.
Umpa hupa. Jikilia umpasa do biska. Patoga wata kiko uba kili wata buki donko.
You have laid her out here and cleaned her up. Now what?
Chobat I kafstu an dile jihulo kuta.
No. Here are some credits. Tell Weddle's man I've paid for your time.
go to town and arrange the funeral.
I can pay for this. It's the least I can do.
No, this is a family affair. And you've done too much for us already. Go.
Che womaktoma. Ya power korka dorundi. Kuna wawanda dongo.
That was a lovely service. Still, I can't come to terms with it.
What? The fact that our mother was worked to death by a fat hut who's somewhere laughing about it right now?
You'll feel better once the hut lies dead at your feet.
Chobat I kafstuan dile jihulo kuta. Stuka sun kanji tavutaya.
I don't know, Tiva. You want to go just shoot this hut in the face?
You're not cut out for that sort of thing, Vet. You will die a little inside.
And this from a Lord of the Sith. You're right, of course.
This is our mother we're talking about, Sena. Our mother!
Let it go. There's been enough pain in this family.
Weak. Weak and cowardly. You are not my sister.
Let's go. Nothing left here. Hey, you saved my life. You know that, don't you? I don't mean literally. Okay, maybe I would have died in that hut's bolt hole, but either way, I wouldn't have come back the same girl.
You're important to me, Vet. Have to keep you safe.
Thank you. Tiva called. She was fine after she cooled off. She was always like that. Maybe you saved her too. Anyway, just wanted you to know.
Thank you.